Welcome to Indian Language News. Our guest today is Anil Khurana, a long-time volunteer. Actually, I remember working with him for the second TiECON, which was almost 24 years or so ago. And I'm glad to see you again, Anil. This time you are leading the manufacturing and materials track. So really looking forward to talking to you about this subject. I think as far as I remember, this is the first time TI has an entire track on manufacturing and materials, and rightly so, because manufacturing has come really booming back in the US and also especially in the Massachusetts and Boston area. So welcome to our show. And I know there is some issue with audio from India, but we will see, you know, hopefully everything runs smoothly. So tell us about the track. What is the idea behind manufacturing and materials track?
Well, thanks, Upendra. First of all, good to reconnect after 24 years, as you said. And I'm also delighted to be hosting this track at TiECON on April 28th this year, TiECON East. So the track, you know, just to provide the inspiration for this. So U.S. manufacturing is in the, you know, focus again. And the reasons for that are a mix of, you know, political activities and investment, but also, you know, geopolitics. So supply chains are changing. That's clearly a trigger. At the same time, you know, there are a lot of innovations happening, whether it's in manufacturing technologies, digital, whether that be in sustainability, you know, batteries, electric vehicles, and so on, but also advanced materials such as, you know, carbon nanomaterials, or, you know, a whole variety of research going on advanced materials that are lightweight materials and so on as well. So that's, I think, one of the reasons for the trigger. At the same time, just like the US, you actually see a global initiative in many countries, Germany, India, China, of course, on advancing manufacturing, partly because traditionally manufacturing has been a blue collar, you know, greasy palms, dirty nails sort of business. But with technology coming in, it has become, as I say, aspirational again. A lot of engineers, even women, are attracted to manufacturing because of those triggers as well. So that's the reason we thought of this track. At the same time, you know, just looking at Boston, if I recall, you know, 30 years ago when I moved to Boston in 1993, manufacturing was reasonably big. There were several high-tech factories in the region, whether those be in networking, whether those be in computers, whether those be in supercomputers. The last 30 years, they have gradually gone down. And so from the state perspective as well, from the ecosystem perspective, there's a desire to bring back manufacturing into Massachusetts, into New England. The recent impetus in semiconductors in particular has created a lot of, tailwinds. So there's a lot of interest in that. When I spoke with the state of Massachusetts executives, you know, in the government, they're very keen on something that we do. And in some ways, the intent of TI is to connect the ecosystem of the state, of the private sector, with the entrepreneurial ecosystem. And investment is coming in as well, right? So that's the reason, of course, all the dots are, you know, T's are crossed, so to say, because investors, entrepreneurs, researchers, corporate, global trends are all aligned in this case.
Yeah, no, I mean, absolutely, you're right that, Manu, especially after, you know, the Biden's initiative on, you know, the semiconductors and all, and already we can see a big uptick going, especially in Massachusetts also, if you put, you know, the medical devices and life sciences and that, that's already, you know, it was a strong manufacturing base. So now coming back to TiECON, so how many panels are going to be in your track? If you can talk about that.
So this track is called Advanced Manufacturing and Materials Track. It has three sessions in there, three panels, as you said. Mm-hmm. There's a panel on smart manufacturing and robotics, which is about digitizing manufacturing, using automation, additive manufacturing, some of those new technologies that are not necessarily physical technologies, but are digital technologies that are enabling manufacturing to be more efficient, more effective, more streamlined, supply chain, and so on. In that panel, we have three or four speakers, and these will include, for example, Ira Moskowitz, who's the CEO of the Robotics Institute in Pittsburgh. Mm-hmm. He's actually a longtime Boston-based gentleman, but he's now in Pittsburgh, so he's one of the speakers. Nathan Kinder, who's the CEO of Tulip Systems, but also, and then we have Mike Tomasi, who's a longtime Boston area manufacturing. The second session is on advanced materials. In advanced materials, we look at a range of things. For example, we have one speaker from 6K, which is a Boston-based, I'd say late-stage startup. They raised $600, $700 million, so you can't call them a startup anymore. But they work on materials, process chemistry, but also battery components, battery systems. And so the 6K CEO and CEO will be there speaking. We'll also have in that session Mark Johnson, who's the now professor at Clemson, but was a senior executive in the Department of Energy until recently and led many programs in materials and semiconductors and computing and so on. So he's another speaker. And third, we will have Chetan Chotani. Chetan is a private equity partner, but also leading a business on sustainability investments in the US. And in particular, he'll talk about things like carbon separation. Third session is on the US manufacturing renaissance. It's a mix of policy, competitiveness, and related. And there again, we'll have three speakers. Christine Nolan is the director of the Massachusetts Advanced Manufacturing Center. So she'll be speaking on how Massachusetts is involved in the US initiatives, policy changes that encourage manufacturing. The second speaker is Nick Santhanan. Nick is the author of a recent book called The Titanium Economy. He's an ex-McKinsey partner who's now CEO of a large private equity fund. And he'll be speaking on what he's seen on US companies that are able to advance manufacturing despite the headwinds that we've seen in the last several years. And the third speaker will be Nigel Francis. Nigel is the CEO of Lyft, which is one of the 16 US federal government manufacturing centers based in Detroit. And he'll be speaking on process changes and how those are being incentivized by the US government. So these are three sessions, and tying them all together is a mix of manufacturing, technology, policy, investments, right? Those are key themes that we think about, not only the industry, but also investors and entrepreneurs and policy changes. Let me just pause
there. Excellent. I think they sound very interesting. And now my question to you is, if somebody wants to attend your track, what is there for them? What they should be looking for, and who should attend your track?
Yeah, I think it goes back to your first question in a way. So I think of this track as an intersection of manufacturing and technology. So first of all, we have in the Boston area a lot of people in technology, and they can perhaps find ideas or part of interest in manufacturing in the region. So if you think about the attendees, but also the speakers, that is a mirror image. I go back to what you mentioned, 1999. Why did I attend TIE? Because I was thinking of technology. I was thinking of being an entrepreneur. I was thinking of who do I need to hire for my startup? Who do we bring on as investors? So the whole ecosystem is going to be there on April 28th. And the attendees are essentially from corporates, entrepreneurs, investors, public policy people, researchers, academia, students. So I think should be of interest to most of them, because this is a next 10, 20 year journey that we will see in both Massachusetts and globally as well.
Yeah. So now, Anil, I know I met you at TiECON, TIE actually, when we were planning for the, I think, second TiECON or something like that. Tell us a little bit about your background, that how you came to TIE and how your journey has been, and what is your background? Our reverse.
So I think, as you said, I got involved in TIECON in 1999. I was a professor at Boston University at that time. And a couple of my friends, in fact, Santana and Yash Shah, who's the current president, were the ones who said, hey, you should come and visit TIE. So I did. I met Desh and Ashok Bhagani and Samir Desai and a few other people. I met you as well. Hmm. And I got inspired to say, let me learn something about entrepreneurship, which I suppose learned that in theory. So I actually attended TIECON, became involved in a couple of the sessions there. And I did a startup after that. I was so inspired, I did a startup. But anyway, so that's my connection with TIE. Then became a charter member. I then actually launched the SIG for life sciences a long, long time ago. And then about 10 years I was away. I was actually in Dubai, and I joined TIE in Dubai as well. And when I returned 3-4 years ago, Yash and Santana asked me to join TIE again. So I'm a charter member. I'm getting gradually re-involved, re-engaged in many of the activities. And this became one particular way I could actually give back to TIE and also get involved. But in terms of my background, I'm an engineer. I grew up in studying engineering in India in the Indian Railroad. I came to the US to do my MBA and PhD. I taught business school for some time. Then I joined private equity and consulting. And for the last 15, 18 years, I was actually leading a manufacturing, automation, or automotive sort of business in strategy and at PwC. I stepped down from that role last year as a global head of that business, about a $7, $8 billion business, to essentially spend time in what I do now. I'm on a couple of boards. I am leading a think tank, and then I invest and mentor startups and founders. So that's what I do.
And you moved back to Boston. Last word on manufacturing and materials track at TiECON. Yes.
Yeah, so just a brief couple of thoughts here. You know, manufacturing, technology, innovation are going to be ahead of us for the next decade or more, both in the US and globally. And I think there'll be a fair amount of investments, ideas, opportunities for everyone. And I hope that all our attendees will have a great time and stay connected. We'll also have the SIG, the Special Interest Group on Manufacturing, continue after TiECON. So hope to stay re-engaged with the attendees and our speakers for the next several years. Thank you.
Excellent. Thank you so much, Anil.